Happy Saturday, everybody. Thanks for logging on for your forecast. Meteorologist Griffin already here with an update on our weather. Sunny, cold, and windy outside across the upstate. Live look at that Hilton Greenville Skycam shows. Tons of sunshine, but not really helping to warm things up all that much. Still in the upper 40s right now in Greenville and Spartanburg, mid 40s in Anderson, low 40s in western North Carolina. It's windy outside, too. That west wind has been coming in pretty strong most of the day. It's up to 17 miles per hour. The sustained winds in Greenville, 18 miles per hour in Clemson, 15 in Anderson. It'll stay kind of windy the rest of the evening tonight, kind of helping to add to that chill factor in the air. Temperatures in the upper 40s, feels like the low 40s right now in Greenville, feels like the upper 30s up towards Asheville and Cullowhee and Hendersonville. And we're talking about a chance for snow heading into Monday. We already have a winter storm watch in effect for Swain County and Graham counties with 2 to 5 inches of snow possible Monday morning through Tuesday morning. We could definitely see some hazardous road conditions develop up there, and we have our own chance for some light snow even as far south as the upstate, but it does look like just the northern part of the upstate up towards northern Greenville County, northern Spartanburg County may get some light snow, but the accumulating chances we'll talk about a little bit more in just a second. For right now, it's cold and dry outside all across the southeast, watching some frigid air across the northern half of the United States up towards the Dakotas and the upper Midwest. You've got some extreme wind chills happening here across the Dakotas. Minus 40 to minus 50 is what it feels like outside right now. Just bitterly cold and not the best weather for the Iowa caucus, which is going on right now. Feels like 19, even as far south as Kansas City right now. 19 degrees below zero, that is. So it could certainly be much worse outside. It's going to be cold no matter how you slice it for us here tonight. Mostly clear as well. Cold, windy, and dry the rest of your Saturday night. Heading into Sunday morning, we'll drop below freezing. Lows will probably be in the mid to upper 20s early tomorrow. Low 20s up towards the mountains. It'll be sunny for the first half of the day tomorrow, but the clouds look to fill in late in the afternoon and into the early evening, but for the most part, a quiet Sunday. Just a little bit windy outside as well as those west winds continue around 10 to 15 miles per hour. Clouds begin to fill back in even more across the area Sunday morning, and here comes that chance for some light snow. I know this looks like a lot. This is just widespread coverage that we could see, but it'll be pretty light snow. I'm not expecting a lot of heavy snow because the cold air is there, but the moisture not so much. But for the mountains, it looks like a pretty decent amount of snow that we could get. You know, a couple of inches certainly on the board for places like Cullowhee and Franklin. Asheville and Hendersonville still looks like it'll be light snow, but we could see, you know, some accumulations up to around an inch, maybe 2 inches. And the northern part of the upstate is where we could get maybe just a little bit of accumulation up towards northern Pickens, northern Greenville, northern Spartanburg counties. That will continue the snow chances throughout the day Monday and for part of Tuesday morning. But by Tuesday afternoon, most of that should dry out. And this accumulating snow chances again around 20 to 30% along the escarpment and the northern half of the upstate. For all the snowfalls out there farther south, probably not going to get much of anything towards Anderson, Abbeville, and Greenwood, but very good snow chances up towards Franklin, Cullowhee, Waynesville, places like that. We could see definitely possibly 4 or 5 inches of snow potentially up towards Bryson City and Robbinsville, where we've got that winter storm watch effect. That's where we'll get the most. Towards Asheville and Hendersonville, could be around 1 to 2 inches in total. So it does look like the first decent snow that we could actually get this season, so far this season anyways. But it does look like to be mostly a mountains event. We'll obviously be focused more on those mountain snow totals as we get a little bit closer. This is just an early look at it. Then beyond that, a big plunge of cold air heading our way for the midweek next week. Still expecting temperatures to drop into the upper teens in parts of the upstate and low teens up towards the mountains Wednesday morning. That's when temperatures will be at their coldest this week. It'll be a relatively short-lived cold snap as temperatures rebound a little bit Thursday and into Friday, but it does look like next weekend we have another push of frigid air that'll be coming in. An early look at the wind chill shows Wednesday morning it could feel like it's below zero up towards Asheville and Hendersonville and feel like the teens when you wake up in parts of the upstate Wednesday morning. And Thursday morning doesn't look to be quite so cold. Relatively short extreme cold snap that's going to be on the way, but it does look like for the mid part of this week and late next week, we could definitely see some really cold air move in. So already got an impact day for Wednesday and a small chance for flurries on Monday for Martin Luther King Day. Here's a quick look at that 4 day. Sunny tomorrow morning, cloudy tomorrow afternoon. Looks like the warmest we're going to be in the short term is tomorrow afternoon as temperatures look to be in the low 50s for highs. Then it's just really cold. Typical mid-January, the coldest time of the year on average for most of next week. Again, impact days Wednesday and Thursday with bitter cold on the way. Actual temperatures low 20s, feeling like the teens in many places of the upstate heading into Wednesday and Thursday. And next weekend also another plunge of cold air there with lows back down to the low 20s, highs upper 30s next Saturday potentially. And the 40 plus of the mountains talk about chances for snow on Martin Luther King Day, lingering into Tuesday morning, drying out by Tuesday afternoon. And impact days Wednesday and Thursday as well, with lows in the teens. Feels like temperatures potentially single digits Wednesday and Thursday heading into next week. Have a great rest of your weekend, everybody.